Hello everyone, my name is Kunal Ghosh and welcome to my new course on TCL Programming Part 2. So this is an extension of TCL Programming Part 1 course that we have done some time back. So there are certain prerequisites to first of all enter into this particular course, and the prerequisites are, first of all, you need to complete the Part 1 of the TCL Programming course should be at least 50% completed. This is the link to the Part 1 course, and this is the icon of the Part 1 course. So you might want to just have a look into this particular course, because most of the concepts that we are trying to teach in this particular course, those are an extension of Part 1 course. So the basic, at least 50% of this particular course should be completed. Okay, that's one of the prerequisites. And the second prerequisite is you need to install VLSI. Now VLSI is a synthesis tool. It's an open source synthesis tools, and the complete guidelines to install the VLSI tool can be found out in this particular link. It's a free course. You just need to watch this particular video and go to that particular section which explains how the VLSI is getting installed. Okay, so the course is called as a complete guide to install open source EDA tools, and this is the icon for it. This is the link for it. It's a free course, so you might just want to have a look into that course, because this is mostly related to how do you tackle EDA tools in the using TCL programming. So that's what this course is all about. So you might want to have a look into this course and install VLSI before entering this particular course. Okay, so with that said, let us try to introduce what all things we are going to cover over here. So it's an extension of what we did in Part 1. So in the Part 1, we have covered these two parts. In the Part 2, we need to cover two more parts, which is converting one of the formats, the SDC format that we have created in Part 1, that needs to convert it into another kind of format which is needed for the STA tool called as Open Timer. It's an open source STA tool. And then we need to generate the output report. So these two things are the more important things that needs to be covered over here, because if you see most of the timing tools or most of the EDA tools, if you look into them, they have got a special kind of timing reports, or they have got a special kind of summary report that gets dumped out. And that's the first thing that a designer needs to look into once they enter into a EDA industry. So that's the kind of the summary report that everyone looks into, and that's why we are trying to solve that problem first using these two points and using the TCL Programming Part 2 course. VLSI is an open source EDA synthesis tool that will take in the RTL netlist as an input and give you the synthesized netlist as an output with all the gates, with all the AND gates, OR gates, and all kind of logic gates that you can see. So we'll stop at this point. In the next video, we'll look into how does the VLSI behaves when you give a RTL as an input and what you get as an output. So we'll look into all those, and then finally we'll look into the TCL programming and how do we modify the output of the VLSI and give it to the open timer tool and so on. So let's try to look into all this from the next video. Thank you.